I'm fed up of all the abuse and all the hateful comments. Now, I'm sitting here today to make this video to answer the question as to why I am this way I am. Now, I'm going to give you my backstory and an explanation, but first, I want to just say, if you saw a person with cerebral palsy, you wouldn't go up to them and take the mickey out of them for being the way they are. If a Down syndrome person were there, like, talking the way they do, you wouldn't mock them. Blind person walking around with a stick and a dog, you wouldn't go and be like, can you see me? Can you see me? You know what I mean? If a person were in a wheelchair, you wouldn't be like, oh, why should we let you through? You've got a wheelchair, it's your own fault. Somebody can't walk, take the mickey out of them. Ooh, you're jealous, I can walk. You know, you might think, oh, I'm being horrible saying all these things, but, you know, you wouldn't do it, would you? You wouldn't take the piss out of somebody with a disability that you can see. You know, like, you can see Down syndrome, you can see cerebral palsy. You can't see what I've got, well, other than the glasses and the no teeth. But that all links together, and I'm going to explain to you why. Now, the comment that I got last week is what pushed me over the edge, because the way they said, oh, I'm not being mean, you clearly were, because the aftermath of that, the comments that you were saying were proper, proper abusive, and I'm like, you play Fortnite? I think that is worse. So it all started on March 4th, 2002. That was the day I was born. A little, small little thing appeared. And, you know, all started out normal. And then they noticed that I was not reacting to light. I was only reacting to, like, bright light. So, say, I don't know, I can't remember, I was a baby, but say if something flashed, I'd notice that. But if something, just normal situations, I wouldn't notice it. So they took me to the doctors, they noticed, and they sent me straight to eye hospital. They said I've got cataracts, they took out the cataracts. And then after that, so basically somebody who used to live like either side of my house was a reporter for the local newspaper. And obviously they heard about the thing and they wrote an article. That's me. I'm going to blur out. No, that's me there. Obviously I'm going to try and blur some of the stuff out because, you know, people shout at me. So that's me in the local paper. So then obviously because that was in the local paper, the bigger papers heard of it. I was in the Manchester Evening News, so like the same people who used to do the MEN. That's also me. There's a little baby. You know, I should have been drowned at birth, but, you know, I can't really say that. And this is from inside of it. So, you know. That's me in the Daily Mail. But that's me in the Daily Mail. I look dead Chinese on it. Wrote a little bit on me. I don't know if there's any more in the Sun. I think there might be, but I can't be bothered looking for it. So yeah, I was in the news, and then obviously because they all them big newspapers saw it, then the TV saw it. Granada News, and I was on Granada Reports. So I'm going to show some of that. The footage is obviously courtesy of Granada Reports in 2002. The woman who says, what a lovely little boy. She's still a presenter, so that's kind of cool. I don't think she'll see this, but you know. Yeah, also Fred the Weatherman was still a thing, so that's also interesting. So yeah, enjoy this little clip.
The baby boy now, who can see properly for the first time, you saw a picture of him before, thanks to a pair of contact lenses. Ben Brown was born with cataracts, which left him with very poor sight.
Yes, it's a condition affecting around 1 in 3,000 babies. But thanks to surgery in Manchester, Ben can now lead a normal life.
Just a month ago, life was all a blur for little Ben Brown. A delicate operation had to be performed before Ben was 4 months old. Any longer, and the part of the brain that controls his vision would simply have shut down. He's been fitted for tiny contact lenses, which Mum Jackie has to change every day, and even some smart spectacles as a backup, though he's not so fond of them. At last, Ben can see what all the fuss is about, though sometimes even babies have to take time out to refocus.
What a lovely little boy.
It's cool. Lovely. This is a really exciting day.
So, like I say, I was on the news. It's so funny just because that woman is still a presenter for ITV now, I'm pretty sure. So, yeah, like I say. And that explains the eyes. That's why I wear big thick milk goggle things. They're really thick. They're not as thick as they were, obviously, on the news, but,
you know, that was 2002 and that was when I had no eyes at all.
Yeah, so now you might be thinking, Ben, that only explains your eyes. Why have you got no teeth? So basically, they never noticed, but when they first, before they did all that, they thought I had Down syndrome. I don't think I do have Down syndrome. They did test and prove that I didn't have it. So, you know, they thought I had Down syndrome when I was a baby, so, you know. That's a compliment, I guess.
His name, when I was about 10 years old, I'd be going to ISO like every 6 months or something.
So, and they noticed that when I moved school and I was in like year four, they noticed that in between my teeth, I had my baby teeth, which were little small, little tiny little things, and the top second teeth, my second teeth were behind my nose, like literally they were behind my nose. And I had bone in between my front teeth, so the top teeth and the bottom teeth. Literally, there was a space between them. Oh, there were a bit of bone between them. So they took that out. That was called supernumerals or something. So they took the bone out and attached some change to it. So in the hopes that my teeth would move because obviously the space was free. Then if they didn't, I could twist them. Now, the teeth didn't move at all. And also when they x-rayed my mouth, they noticed that the teeth were deformed anyway. So they took the teeth out. So I've not got second teeth at the front. So that's why I had no teeth at all. And obviously because all the conditions linked, you know, all my mouth's disgusting. Like, because there's a space there, my bottom front teeth have gone forward because they've not had the top teeth to like stop them. They're supposed to be like that. But when they made me false teeth, they go like that, which you're not supposed to do. They're supposed to be like that. Like the top one's supposed to be in front. I don't know. I'm not a teethologist. But so what they've done is they've cleared all my mouth. And obviously, because you've got to be like 18 to stop growing or something, I have to wait till then. That's why I'm 16 now and I've not got anything. But what they're going to do, they're going to get some bone out the side of me, unless there's enough bone there. They're going to put some things in, screw type things, and they're going to put teeth on them. And then they're going to sort all my other ones, like crown them and things. And then I'm going to have nice teeth. Like, I might still have a wonky eye, but, you know, quite a lot of people have wonky eyes. And they said, back when I was a kid, they might be able to put, when I was like a baby, they said they might be able to put like contact lenses on the inside of my eye that you don't take out sort of thing. So, you know, instead of wearing glasses or contact lenses, it'll be a permanent contact lens type thing. So that, by the time I die, I should be normal looking, hopefully. But yeah, that is why I look the way I do. And now you know, so you don't need to comment on it. Because if next time somebody comments anything like mean about the way I look or, you know, I'm just going to link them this video because, you know, it's my story sort of thing. And yeah, that's what I mean. It just bugs me that people, because it's classed as a disability. It's called Nance-Horan syndrome or something. It affects your eyes, your teeth, your behaviour. That's why I'm a bit of a weirdo, if you know me. Used to be dead naughty and stuff. Like, proper naughty. But yeah, I'm fat as well, so that's not very good. I've not had a shave for ages, I need a haircut and all that lot. But you know, I try and get through life. You know, you see all these people, you know, it's a disability. It affects 1 in 1 million people, whereas you get Down syndrome, it's quite common, especially in my buddy's school. Jesus Christ, I'm sure they were all down. But yeah, you know, that's what I mean. So now, please don't like take the piss out of me in the comments. I know it's freedom of speech and you can say what you like, but you know, just think about it like this. If a Down syndrome person being a Down syndrome person, you wouldn't take the piss out of them for being a Down syndrome person, but you'd take the piss out of me for my appearance. So it's the same thing. It's not as disabled, but it's disabled. And I don't mean to sound offensive towards Down syndrome people and all the people that I talked about at the start, like cerebral palsy and all that. I'm not taking the mickey out of them, and I'm not saying what I've got's worse. I'm saying that people don't really take the mickey out of them as much as they would me because they don't know that I've got a disability. If you saw somebody in a Morrison's car park who, in part, in a disabled spot, who was severely disabled, like, you know, severely disabled, you know, you'd know that they're severely disabled. You don't know that I'm disabled. You know, I'm not going to be a blue badge person or, you know, I'm not going to get disability benefits when I'm older, mainly because I'm white. But so, yeah, I mean, I'm able to work. I'm able to live my life. I just look a bit freaky.
That's why if I ever sign up for Tinder, we all have to thank Adobe for Photoshop. But yeah, that is where I'm going to end this video. Thanks for listening. Thanks for what's name. Hopefully people won't be as arsey with me and about my appearance and stuff in the comments. So yeah, go bully some fat people. Wait, I'm fat. Anyway, I'm BBHAXS, and I am signing off.